sky. Version of the enchanted harpont. And let me assure you, getting there is a beach. I'm going to describe the process a little bit, step by step, because at this point, frankly, I'm not sure I would be able to repeat it myself if I have to. Okay. Take my meter and use the pointer. I don't know if you noticed, but I'm currently on the other side of that damn teleporter. Strelok. Don't worry, he's safely on the ground. That's one very important point. If you want to go wandering around this area, it's better to do it if Strelok has been knocked on the ground. That happens quite easily, actually, when we probably throws a grenade or something, it just falls down and you can just leave him be if you want to. Another thing that's very special about this particular save is that it was actually my first time to properly play into the end of Clear Sky. With all those hundreds, probably thousands of hours I had spent in the game, I had only visited the ending once. But basically I ran through Limanska, I ran through the hospital level just to go and see the ending. But I wasn't really believing it. Okay, but let's check the important detail now. Clear Sky has lots and lots of invisible barriers everywhere, and the slippery grounds, more than Shadow of Chernobyl actually. And to get here, into this platform, which is so close to the area where you would be going anywhere, anyway, you have to take quite a long way to get to. Just to show it, these stairs aren't exactly in good shape. Don't fall down. Let's go back up there. Okay, now I can show that here. So first of all, not meant for players to go into. So, in the NPP area, there's this whole half of the facility that's basically blocked off. But there was this one specific point on the pipes where a grenade boosted jump will get you through. Unfortunately, once you're in that area, you can't go Twilight Zone proper. So I was moving further, and I ended up there, at this point. From there, I managed to jump into that platform. See, that's my stuff over there. All the extra ammo, a gun maybe? I don't know. And now that's where the really exciting or tedious or hardcore part started. I jumped from this platform to this platform. And no, my jumping power wasn't enough on its own. The technique I used here was to throw a grenade ahead of me. Basically, I stood over there. No, I think I stood on this ledge to get this full run. I stood over here. I threw a grenade ahead of me so that it would fall somewhere next to this platform, and then I ran and then I jumped. And I didn't even know if it was possible to do it, but there's this dead weight indicator, as I call it. It's like, if your dead body reaches a place, then it's worth a try and check out. Maybe, just maybe, you can reach the place alive. So, from here to here, I can't remember anymore if I landed on this ladder thingy or here, but somehow I didn't. And as I said earlier, I'm not even sure if I would be able to repeat it. It wasn't necessary, so it was crazy. But now, once we are past that teleporter, things get much easier. Things get more traditional, I would even say. So, just gonna enjoy the view. Hold most of the comments, lest I give away too much. I did. reload. Oops. Oh, fuck. Okay, I'm gonna have to reload from the platform.
Artifacts actually have much weaker effects.
yeah. And that's how you do it. Okay. just the decoration. Well, okay, not with the letters, but just the decoration. I know that